viruses and other types of attacks. And ethical hacking, which is to protect our system from being hacked. And finally, we learn to manage incidents whenever our computer breaks down or when it's by someone else. So moving on to the key topic, as you can see on the screen, here are some words that can actually hurt someone when you post online without thinking twice. So, so as you can see, right, something like bimbo, weirdo, freak, everything that you post online, you can actually hurt someone. Okay. So, I know that many of us do post such information online. And of course, it comes natural whenever we talk to others and post such stuff. But actually, this concept is cyberbullying. So let's take a look at some other examples. Nowadays, we are actually connected everywhere. So many of us will actually WhatsApp our friends, use Facebook, Instagram to connect with people and actually communicate with one another. But because of the internet, many of us have actually posted a lot of irregular stuff online that can actually hurt people without us knowing. And whenever we are on the internet, we are actually anonymous. For example, when you play your Clash of Clans or League of Legends, right, you will actually hide your identity and not let people know your real name, and rather put a nickname to hide your identity. And when you are playing games, you can actually insult someone really on the internet and not letting anyone know that you are the person behind the computer. So these have caused people to become more vulnerable, to become victims of a bully. So let's take a look at a survey. A survey was done on 25 countries last year, and China was actually the 12th country in the world to be cyberbullied. But now, it's a major country, and that is why. It's the biggest country, and that is why it can be based on cyberbullying cases. And of course, while we look at China, right, Singapore, a smaller country, is the second in place, with 58% of us subjected to online bullying. So you can see at the large number, which is quite scary. So this is because we can tweet, like, and share our views freely on the internet, such that the bully can actually use this information to target you online, and you become the easiest thing if you have more information online. So the more you post, the more easier you become one of the victims. So yesterday, just before yesterday, Instagram released a new feature that is similar to Snapchat, and now everyone can post their stories. Have anyone used it before?
Yeah.
So I hear a lot of replies. So yes, this was actually released yesterday, and now people can actually post their videos freely online and share their story with everyone. But because of this, right, you must know that you need someone to target you, can actually steal all these videos and use to target you one day. So with just one click on the keyboard, cyberbullies can actually get your profile immediately and share away people information from you. So according to another survey, 3 out of 10 of these cyberbullies actually say that they do it for revenge, which means that they were once bullied and therefore they decided to take revenge on others by bullying someone else. 2 out of 10 say that the victim deserved it and therefore they bully. So for example, your friend anger you or show off to school and you decided to take revenge, then you will start to think that the victim deserved it and you start to cyberbully someone else. 1.2 out of 10 says that they do it for fun, and 0.8 say that they do it for anger or hatred. So 2 out of 10 of them say that they do it for peer pressure. So peer pressure is actually quite an excuse. Let's take a look at what does peer pressure mean that can cause someone to bully others. So let's take, for example, we have Tom. And then Tom bullies Joanne online by posting information about her online. And then others thought that it's real. They start to join in and like and comment or whatever that Tom posted about Joanne. And then you, as a bystander, you don't know what to do. But the natural reaction is to join in. Why do you want to join in? Because if you do not join in, then you might think that, oh, others might start to target me, thinking that I support Joanne. So what happens? You will start to think that others are bullying Joanne, and if I don't bully Joanne, others will then think that I stand on Joanne's side and end up as the next target. So what happens? Many of us will start to join in and like and share. So as this happens, right, the victim will start to feel very fearful, because every day everyone is bullying you, including and no one is supporting her. So of course, one out of 10 of them say that they need personal reasons. So out of so many different reasons, right, the common ways are quite a lot. So many of us bully others in very common ways. And there are many ways to hurt a reputation of someone. So for example, you spoof someone's account. Someone is caught wrong and then you start to spoof his account by putting media on his head and post online and start to post fake information about him online, making others believe or start to ruin his own reputation. This is considered cyberbullying when you create another fake account. So what happens next? You will then post harassment messages to fake the person. So bystanders will start to post hurtful messages and actually hurt the team. So see, these are quite remarks. So doxing is to post real information of someone online. So you'll start to post that person's email, address, phone number, age, and of course the information there is fake, okay? It's not real. Okay. So of course some even resort to posting the poster online. So this is known as doxing and is considered part of cyberbullying. Harassment is to threaten someone, threaten someone online and start to post things that may hurt the person or make the person feel fearful. So under the harassment act, the worst that you can do is to join in and laugh. If you are a bystander who join in, you can be charged under the defamation act. Defamation is to post something online and hurt the other person's reputation. Hurt the other person's reputation. So for example, I'm sure that many of you saw this video. She actually said, "You know who I am," and the information went viral online and it ruined her own reputation. Similarly, if you post something that actually hurt someone that has the same effect as this, then you can be charged 2 years jail, a fine, or even both. Under the Harassment Act, there are three types of cases that you can be charged for if you are a bystander or you cyberbully as a bully. Harassment, alarm, and distress. So that this guy from Hong says, "Guys, do you know that Joanne loves Ben a lot? LOL." So it's a fake remark. And the people start to say, start to spread this rumor. And he goes, he wants to hurt Joanne, and Joanne says, "Now everyone is making rumors of me, what should I do?" So she starts to call Tom to stop posting such information. But then Tom continues, then Tom has broke the harassment act and can be charged. Next, fear and provoking violence is to post information that can cause fear on someone else. So Tom says, "Joanne, don't let me see you or I'll beat you up in school." Please don't beat me up, I'm sorry. So Joanne wants to stop. And of course he doesn't stop, then of course this is known as online harassment. Cyberstalking, which is quite common nowadays, is not quite enough to stop, I think. So we have Joanne and Tom. Tom says, "Hi Joanne, how are you doing today?" Then Joanne says, "I'm fine today." Tom starts to post irregular remarks. "Oh, I saw the post about you and another guy who hang out with you on that night. I hope that you had a great night." Okay? So she remembered it was coming out. And Joanne said, "What do you mean?" So Tom starts to post the picture that Joanne posted online and shared it with his friends. Though Joanne did not share outside of his family, the public friends, Tom actually shared it out. And he actually told Joanne to make Joanne feel scared. So Joanne said, "Stop." And Tom continues. Then Tom has broke the harassment act once again. And you can face 1 year jail, 5,000 or even more. Maximum is 2 years jail, and 10,000. And if you continue to post such information that may hurt the person, despite after constant reminders not to post, then this will double up and go as it continues. So you can see the severity of bullying online. So in such cases, I often want to make for the team bully. What makes them do it and why do they do it? So as they start to think of this information and thinking about who bully her and why has the person want to bully her, then you will affect your daily life and you'll have low self-esteem. Low self-esteem is when you start to think of very depressing thoughts and of course feel fearful and you will start to feel depressed. So such are actually daily emotional changes. And when emotional changes come by, you will experience physical changes like eating disorders, which is to eat irregularly, such as really eating during the time or not eating at all. So according to academic situation, according to a survey done by sportbullying.gov, many of them can actually skip school after being cyberbullied because they are afraid that the next day they go back to school and everyone will start to know about them and talk bad about them. So as they have done so, according to a 2005 study by Chama Pedai's Journal, 10%, people with 10% higher grades will actually be 20% less likely to be bullied. So what does this mean? If you come from a very a background that is threatening, or you start to post information online every day of your life, and the bully finds you easy to bully, then she will target you.
Because bullying online is part of So stop and think before you cook.
So, cross my fingers really listen. The victim further, and of course to report the incident together with the victim because of the deed sharing. So basically, I'm almost coming to the end of my presentation. Just remember to report the incident every time you are traveling today and help your friends whenever they are in need of help, and not add on any other remarks that are sarcastic and hurt that person. So here are the following contacts that you might want to contact in case you are cyberbullying.